Hello, and welcome to invited lecture of additive manufacturing of electrical machines. My name is Professor Ants Kallast, and I'm coming from Tallinn University of Technology, Estonia. First of all, I want to say that I'm sorry that I can't be at present of the conference, but as the pandemic situation is as it is, so I have to give you the online presentation, but hopefully it is still as good as it is. Let's start with the topics and additive manufacturing of electrical machine. Before I start to speak about it, first of all, I want to speak where I'm coming from and who I am. So I'm coming from Estonia. Where is Estonia? Estonia is at west from the Russia, close to the St. Petersburg. We have the neighbors at Latvia, and on north from us is Finland. Estonia is a very small country. It has size around 45,000 square kilometers, and population is only 1.32 million people. And our capital is Tallinn, where I'm also coming from. In Estonia, we are speaking Estonian language, and also English is very widely spoken, and also it's possible to speak here Russia, as we have quite a big Russian-speaking population. I'm coming from Tallinn University of Technology, or shortly TALTE. It's the only technical university in Estonia, what was established in 1918. And here we are teaching and doing research work on in all engineering part, plus natural and social sciences. I'm coming from electrical machine group, and I'm also leading electrical machine group. Electrical machine group is a research group within the Department of Electrical Power Engineering and Mechatronics in TALTE University, and is specialized in electrical machines and trials. As you can see here, a picture of our group, and you can see that we are quite young research group. So what are our research main fields? Are basically everything what is related to electrical machines. Our research and development projects are basically synchronous generators for wind application. We are working with new permanent magnet materials for use in sustainable energy application. We work with electrical machines diagnostics and prognostics. Also design and optimization of different type of electrical machines and drives. One new topic for us is additive manufacturing of electrical machines, where we have been working already for 4 years going on this topic. And novel approaches to electrical machine fault diagnostics. And also we are part of Iseauto, Estonian first self-driving car, and we are doing also some educational projects. A little bit more about our research field. As I said, one of our research field is permanent magnet synchronous generators for wind application. These ones are special type of machine developed directly in Tallinn University of Technology. And we have designed this type of machine starting from 5 kW up to 3 MV. Our second field is novel permanent magnet material for use in sustainable energy application. Basically, in this project, we have developed a novel type of neodymium magnets, where we were trying to get rid of this prosium, what is one important component of permanent magnet to get its characteristic out, but it is making also this type of magnets quite expensive. In this project, our main task was to research new materials and grades for wind generators and find solution how to use this type of magnets in electrical machines. Today, main presentation is about additive manufacturing of electrical machines. As I said already, we have been dealing with additive manufacturing for 4 years, and we have developed a couple of prototypes of this type of machines, and we have done a huge amount of research work on the material and how to produce electrical machines through additive manufacturing, but about this I'll speak later. We have done our work on quite a lot of work on diagnostic of electrical machines and the prognostics. We have mainly concentrated on induction machine rotor and stator faults, but also now we are moving more towards the synchronous machines, and the main purpose of this research is to diagnose machine online and from electrical parameters. Also, we have looked novel approaches for electrical machine and fault diagnostics. In this part, we are concentrating how to find electrical machine faults through how to find machine faults online. Basically, we have developed mobile phone apps to make a pre-diagnostic of electrical machine. So also, we have built up our own cloud computation environment to measure direct machine electrical characteristics and make assumptions what are the problems of machines. And also we have we are working on inverse problem theory to have a more precise diagnostics of electrical machine to recognize directly what are the symptoms of the machine faults. Then we are dealing with design and optimization of electrical machines and drives. Basically, we have working to on electrical drive system where we are trying to take into account machine design, also with control and how to implement everything into full one system and how to design working system through this. Then our research group is dealing with EaseAut or Estonian first self-driving car. It's a TalTech self-driving car what is developed in TalTech, where electrical machine group was responsible of full wiring of the machine, placement of sensor and actuators, tuning and testing of traction drive systems. And at the moment, this car is driving in the university, and if somebody is coming to Talte, we are able to show how the machine is working. We have a very nice laboratory for testing electrical machines. We can test machines up to 50 kilowatts, and we have full equipment to carry out thermal measurements of electrical machines and also to do electrical motor drive system cloud to monitor and analyze with modular data acquisition system of Tevetron. Basically, this one is allowing to measure whatever electrical parameters we want. So if somebody is interested in our lab, you are welcome to visit us and we can give you more detailed tour of our lab, but we have very nice working laboratory. Our group, as I said, our group is carrying out basically research work in all field of what is related to electrical machines and control of electrical machines. Our group consists of 3 professors, 3 experienced researchers, and 9 PhD students at the moment. So here are our contacts of our group, and if you are interested, please contact us through email or you can call. So let's move further to the additive manufacturing of electrical machines, to our main topic. So to start to speak about additive manufacturing, a little bit about electrical machines. As we know, the electrical machine has been invented already around 200 years ago. It depends on where we are starting to count when the electrical machine was fully established. And electrical motors are playing a key role in electrical system as they are producing almost all electricity is produced by the help of electrical machines, and almost half of electrical consumption is done by electrical motors. So we can find these motors from very small to very big, large machines. We can find different type of machines. And as I said, they have been developed already for 200 years, or a little bit less. But is there still something to do? If you look what is pushing forward the electrical machine designs, and we can see here, we have the basic legislation, where the governments are pushing us to make think more green, pushing us new energy efficiency, where we are moving towards a higher efficient machine. The machine have to produce less emission and so on. And also the machine consumers are expecting always a better machine. They want better performance, better functionality, higher reliability. So this one is all is influencing what is expected from electrical machines. And of course, there is a competition who are producing the electrical machines. They want to have some kind of advantage in their machines. And also the technology is developing further. We have new designs, new materials, there are new dimension requirements. But what about manufacturing of the electrical machine? If you look at the picture here on the left, what is electrical machine produced 100 years ago, and nowadays how they are produced, then there is basically no change. The manufacturing of electrical machines has always been with the same possibilities and same solutions, only a little bit higher automation has come into it. So is there to move towards somewhere? And from there, we get to the additive manufacturing as a new manufacturing way, what is coming into the market more and more. What is additive manufacturing? Basically, it is computer-aided design, where we have 3D object scanner, and what is feed into the 3D printer, where 3D printer, by layer, is adding material and creating through this an object. That's why it is also called additive manufacturing, as it is adding material to create the object. And when the object is ready, we can say we get the full working machine, if it would be so simple. And I will now present or go through all the steps how to design electrical machine and what the problems are, who is additive manufacturing, and hopefully it will come into the real market also soon. But at the moment, the mainly electrical additive manufacturing of electrical machine is in the research state. Why to speak about additive manufacturing and what new concepts or new advancements is giving additive manufacturing? And the main advantage of additive manufacturing is that it is possible to create parts with almost any geometry with little or no added cost. Basically, here are some pictures of additively manufactured object that can see very complex shape what can be produced, or here we can see printed, 3D printed piece. This one is one monument what was built in Estonia, and there was printed thousands of very detailed piece out with additive manufacturing, just for information. And there are basically applications for additive manufacturing. So what is it offering then? It is offering new ground ground for innovation in low volume production due to faster and cheaper prototyping, reduced lead time and shorter supply chains. Also, it is offering tools-free production, meaning that basically we need only printer to produce something. We don't need hammer, we don't need different grinding tool and so on, but we need only one tool, and it is making it should be very simple. The advantage, definitely what we have with additive manufacturing, is that it can be produce highly complicated structures, and this advantage can be used in many, many fields, and also it will come into the design of electrical machines, and the advantage is huge, but can be used to develop new type of electrical machine. Also, there is one advantage that you can produce prototypes with much shorter time. And as in this production system, you don't need human involvement, which will result in improved manufacturing tolerances. So there is a lot of advantages, and the main field where we can see where the additive manufacturing can be used is rapid prototyping. Basically, we can very quickly work out our design to 3D computer-aided design and feed it into the 3D printer, and we have our prototype. So we can say it's very quick. Also, rapid tooling. Basically, we can build our own tools, special tools, and it is something what is very important in manufacturing and in research work on in laboratories, as it is making life much quicker and easier. And then we get to the rapid manufacturing, or basically very quick manufacturing, because we are reducing the amount of tools what we are needing. In one way, yes, it is something what are the possibilities, but there are also a lot of drawbacks why it is not yet competing with traditional or conventional manufacturing. And the main reason is that you can't produce mass. You can't use additive manufacturing in mass production. So let's look at these pros and cons of additive manufacturing. As I said, the main pro is that you can basically do individualized structures. You can produce whatever kind of shape you are. You have the great freedom of design. And if you have the idea, whatever shape you want to produce, it's very easy to manufacture. And this one gives you the speed of producing. The speed is advantage if you're speaking about prototyping, but if we are speaking about mass production, then as I already said, additive manufacturing is not very quick producing the mass production, but for prototyping, it's very quick compared to the traditional or conventional manufacturing, because if I look how long for me producing some 50 watt new type of electrical machine is taking, then through 3D printing, I can get almost functional prototype out in a couple of days. But if I go to the manufacturer, it is taking a lot of longer. And of course, you have no tools and no molds required, making this, especially for prototyping, very quick. But it is not so simple that you get right away fully functional system out. As we can see from the right picture, you don't get totally finished product, But if usually you need some additional tooling to finalize your product. And as I already mentioned several times, it limited suitable for industrial mass production. And also one problem is coming that you are usually limited with multi-material capability, meaning that most of additive manufacturing tools or 3D printers are printing usually one material at a time. And this one is putting a huge problems to produce fully functional electrical machine, but you still can have several advantages. So from machine point of view, what advantages we can get from additive manufacturing? Of course, we can use this advantage that we can produce complex geometry. We can print fine walls from starting from 60 micrometers. We can see here one picture of electrical machine rotor stator where we can see specially constructed pieces with lattice structure to reduce weight and enhance the characteristics of the machine. We can increase the slot filling factor. Basically, we can produce special windings with special shapes so that we have to use less air in air gap between the windings. We are able to produce different cooling channels and cooling heat guides to enhance machine cooling capability. With additive manufacturing, it is possible to reduce machine weight so that we produce complex shape of machine and we are not wasting the material for just structural purposes. And with the design, it's possible to enhance the air gap magnetic flux. So there are quite a lot of challenging advantages that can be taken into account on the design of electrical machines. The question is more how to do it. And before we can start even to take this advantages into account, we have to look what are the challenges what we have to overcome. And the main challenges are related to material properties, basically mechanical properties. Then we get to the electromagnetic behavior. Of course, material properties are related also to electrical material or electrical characteristics of the material, but also how to design three-dimensional magnetic field, because at the moment electrical machine design is usually done in 2D fields and only for full design or for looking how the machine exactly is operating we are looking three-dimensional design, but the main design is usually done in 2D, and it means we are restricted ourselves thinking how to go to three-dimensional magnetic field. And this one is also related to reliable function integration, how to put all these advantages into the machine design. But before we go to the design and material of the additive manufacturing of electrical machines, I will give short overview of the different 3D printers or printers that are used for additive manufacturing, as there are quite a lot of different printers. We have Watt photopolymerization printer, we have material jetting printer, we have binder jetting, material extrusion, sheet lamination, direct energy deposit printer, powder bed fusion. So which printer to use? So shortly, what is a Watt photopolymerization printer? Basically, they are stereolithography or digital light processing printers, where they are using thermoset material, which is reactive to the light. And when we are giving a light to the liquid, it is hardening and we can lift out the object, 3D object. It has a lot of advantages. We can produce isotropic material. It is a most precise printer out there at the moment. It is giving very nice smooth finishing of the material. You can produce very detailed features, and there are several different material characteristics what you can get out of there, but sadly you can use only thermoset materials, so they are not suitable for printing electromagnetic components. The next one is material jetting. It's basically similar to the previous printer. Only difference is that now the liquid is spread into the builder platform where it is hardened with UV light. It is again allowing you to produce very complex shape things with different materials even. You can put one material, you can add color, but sad thing is that again, it is limited to the materials what the harden at UV light, and you can't use to print some electromagnetic components. So binder jetting is already allowing us to print metal parts. The printer is basically working with metal powder and binder agent what is put to glue together all the metal parts. It is very interesting printer. Only problem is that characteristics of the material what you get out from there are not suitable for printing electrical machines, because the binder unit is not giving you very good mechanical strength, and also it is not giving you very good electromagnetic properties out of it. So it is again to print nice objects, but for real tooling it is still lacking, and maybe it can be used for some special application, but for general purposes to build electrical machine, it is not very suitable printer. Material extrusion technology, or fused deposit modeling, I hope everybody knows this one. This one is very simple 3D printer, very common nowadays, where you have the filament what is melted with temperature control unit, and the liquidized plastic basically is dropping out to the platform, and the robot is putting it into the right place where you want it. Again, very useful tool. Also, we have it in our lab, and we are using it a lot to build different holders, different cabins, but for printing electrical machine it's not suitable, as it is printing plastic, not electromagnetic components. Here are some examples what we have printed with this printer in our lab. We have printed basically holder for electrical machine, we have printed a holder for speed sensor, and different holders or holder for a magnetic measurement unit. And it's useful, and I know that it is very important in different research labs to get your work done very quickly. But if you want to speak about electrical machines, we have to look further from the 3D printers. So we get to the sheet lamination or laminated object manufacturing, where basically it's similar as electrical machine is produced, where we have, for example, electrical steel sheet what is usually stamped out. Here we are using laser to cut our required object out, and then we are using heat roller to glue this together. Sad thing is that it is not allowing us to produce very complex designs, and it is not possible to produce hollow parts, and it is very good for to produce large objects what are not very expensive, but producing electrical machines it is not very good solution. What now happened? Now, then we have direct energy deposit, or DAD. Direct energy deposit is basically same thing what is electrical welding, or very similar to it, where we have the material wire is coming onto the bed, and with electric beam or with laser, we melt it and put it on top of the layer by layer to each other. It is very good for repairing parts or producing large 3D printed parts. But the problem this one is it is not giving you very good resolution, or you can't produce very thin fall systems. And at the moment, it's quite costly printer, and you don't need support structures. And with this one, we get to the final printer, what is called powder bed fusion, or selective laser melting, or electric beam melting. How this one is working? This one is working so that we have the powder, metal powder, or whatever powder what you can melt with laser. The three-quarter plate is giving you very thin layer of the material on top, and then the laser is melting it. When the all full object what you want to be solid is melted, it is adding next layer and next layer till you get your full object. And basically you have final object as seen in this video here. So this technology is already very good because you can basically fully melted material get out of it. Here are some examples where this selective laser melting, or SLM, has been used. Here are one holder, what is basically traditional or conventionally manufactured, and then it is optimized with structure so that your mechanical strength has been kept the same, but the material what is just for holding purposes has been removed, and we get a very strange shape, but still it has the same mechanical properties. Here is one example of additively manufactured full rocket, and here is one example where again the structural topological optimization has been used to produce braking pads for cars. And again, this one solution is allowing us to produce very complex shape of objects with very light weight, but keeping the mechanical strengths same or better compared to the conventional manufacturing technology. So this technology is best suited for producing electrical machines. So what we can take from this manufacturing technology to electrical machines? So what we can do, we can produce solid structures. We can produce different mesh structures. We can produce complex 3D shapes. We can build different cooling channels, what are all needed in electrical machines. And all these advantages can be used to produce electrical machines. The question is more how to implement this one into electrical machine design. And second advantage from this one is that basically we can produce the material without waste of the material. As when we are printing the object, the leftover of the material is purely the powder what we are using, and the powder we can reuse for producing next object. So how to design additively manufacturing electrical machine? What we have to do? We need the material. We have the powder of the electric of the material. We have to melt it. We have to get the right characteristic of the material suitable for electrical machine. Doesn't matter, is it electrical steel, or is it windings, or is it full structure. In there, we have to look carefully how to set our printing, how to and what are the requirements for post-processing. What is post-processing is, again, after finishing the printing, we have to clean the object, or maybe we have to heat treat it, or maybe we have to do something else. So there are some post-processing procedure. What we then can get the material characteristics, what we can implement into the machine design. In the machine design, what is difficult or what is opportunity through additive manufacturing is that we can work out new topology to take into the advantages what we get from additive manufacturing into the machine topology, and we can design our custom core structures, we can design our winding structure, and basically work out new design methodology. And with this one, as the additive manufacturing is allowing us to produce complex, very complex shapes with different lattice structures, with different 3D shapes, we can implement now new optimization tools to optimize our machine according to our requirements. And it is not limited by the manufacturing process, what is at the moment huge disadvantage from a conventional manufacturing, that we can't produce whatever shape we want. And of course, with design, we get to the thermal treatment of the heat exchange topology of the machine, where we can enhance our machine heat extraction by different cooling channels, by different heat extraction units. And this one is again something new, what is not taken into account usually in the conventional machines. And it means also that at the moment there is not existing good solutions, and they have to be worked out. And then we have also the losses, what is at the moment quite big challenge, but we get to this point later in this presentation. So loss reduction, what we can do on additive manufacturing. First of all, producing the material itself. At the moment, the 3D printed materials for electrical machines are not very well researched, and there is still a lot of work to be done to find the best suited material where we get the most advantages out. Is it a material isotropic, anisotropic? What are its hysteretical loop? Are we printing soft material? Are we printing hard material, or basically permanent magnets? How to get the best conductors out of it? This all work is still something what have to be done. Then loss reduction. One of the disadvantages of additive manufacturing is that we are printing basically solid unit. And as I said, at the moment, with existing 3D printers, it's possible to print only one material at a time. It means if we compare it to traditional method how to reduce eddy currents, we are using laminated cores to suppress eddy currents. Then through additive manufacturing, we have to find new ways how to do it. I later show how what in our research work is going on. There are some advantages what can be taken into account, like here shown. We can print basically honeycomb structures and reduce eddy currents. But the question is always how to isolate the material from each other if we can print only one material at a time. We can implement new heating system basically, or different composite materials to enhance the machine heat treatment and increase through these losses, or decrease the we can use new winding types, for example, hairpin winding or different turnaround winding structures to reduce copper losses in the machine. And for material scientists, is a challenge how to work out new materials. So a little bit about the material itself and what we have done. Here are some of our preliminary research work, what we have done, and some example what problems are coming with 3D printing of metal material. So what we are looking from electrical machines are good magnetic properties. It means basically good hysteretical loop, reduced eddy current losses. From the conductors, we are looking that they are very good conductors. And from mechanical part, we have to look that there is mechanical strengths, as it have to be, there is no porosity and so on. As we can see from here in the pictures, we get the porosity if we are printing the machine, we get even the cracks, because if you think how the SLM is working, then it has a hot spot always, and you get the thermal stresses in the material, and it is easy to get micro cracks in the material, what you can't see during the printing process, but afterwards you are surprised how it is affecting your mesh magnetic characteristics of the material. We can print soft magnetic, hard magnetic material. In our research, we have concentrated mainly on soft magnetic, because hard magnetic, it's you can print permanent magnets, but as electrical machine mainly consists of soft magnetic material and conductors, and we have concentrated on soft magnetic material. And challenge is here, of course, to get thin hysteretical loop and how to reduce eddy currents. How the printing process is going on, here is example of our lab where we have the Realizer SLM 3D printer. Basically, we have a computer where we feed in our 3D object to the machine, and in here, in this chamber, we are printing our object. In this 3D printer, we can print 70 millimeter diameter object with height 75 millimeter, and we are using 120 watt laser for printing. And here are some examples for what we have printed for measuring printed material characteristic. We have printed different type of objects, and we have measured their mechanical and electromagnetic properties. Here you can see also, if you are trying to print different things, you also need some additional support structures what have to be removed when you have printed the object. So this one is again one limit of additive manufacturing, that you don't get right result out of it. Here again, some example what can happen during the printing. We can see different cracks because of the inner stresses, what can happen. Also, here is not picture of the growing, and also small micro cracks what can't be seen visually, and some porosity. Again, some example of the porosity what can happen in the machine. And here is one important thing, that when we are starting to print the material, it is not so simple to print, because the printing material, what is the result of the printing, depends heavily on how you adjust your printing parameters. Here is example of how quickly your laser is scanning the material, or basically melting it, and what is your density. Of course, the slower you are printing, the higher density you get of the material, but the problem is that also the printing time is increasing strongly. In the previous samples, what you saw, the printing was done in 72 watts with a with a laser power of 72 watt and with a speed of 1 meter per second. And of course, environment where you're printing is also influencing what is your final result. Here are just one example of the hysteretical loop what we have measured and different losses at different speed or how the hysteretical loop is changing and some ideas how to reduce the eddy current of the machine. Here are some of our research part of the reduction of eddy currents. What are your possibilities? We are looking for a solid structure with some conventional way, basically adding just one air cap between or several air caps, or we can go even to the strange shapes to reduce the eddy currents, but this research work is going on at the moment and I can't give you the final results. So as I said, not only the printing itself is something what is challenging, but also the post-processing. As I said, one huge part is that you don't get the final result out of it, but you get the result where you have also support structures what have to be afterwards, after the printing, removed to get your final results. This one is one picture of our printed electrical machine part where we have the coil holder and basically the stator part here. And we can see the support structures what have to be removed. And not only the removing of the support structure is something what you have to do afterwards, but also important part is heat treatment of the metal parts to release the inner stresses and to enhance its magnetic characteristics. So what are the possibilities what can be taken into account on producing machine through additive manufacturing? As I said, we have the possibility to produce novel machine designs to implement. We have basically total freedom of how we design our machine from conventional to very strange shapes of machine. We can use optimization tools to enhance machine characteristic or to be application-oriented machine characteristics. We have the possibility to produce new type of windings. We have possibility to enhance our material characteristics. And we have possibility to integrate different functionalities, different cooling channels, different application-oriented machines to produce. From the cooling, there is a huge amount of possibilities what you can do with the cooling. You can basically implement new cooling channels what are directly taking away the heat from the hot spots of the machine. You can produce different heat guides in the system or cooling channels into the system, or even produce windings with hollow structure to guide through the heat exchanger. Some examples also of the machine what have been done already in research field. These ones are not our research, but done in the different universities. Here is one example of producing machine shaft with integrated lattice structure to reduce the machine weight and enhance the machine characteristic. Here is one air-cooled heat exchanger for electrical machine to enhance the cooling of the rotor. Here is one example of produced basically permanent magnet machine frame. And here is one example where 3D printed stepper machine rotor with small breeches to enhance the machine electromagnetic behavior. Here more some rotors where we can see topological optimization of the rotor to enhance the machine performance. And again, we can see already complicated shape, what is very difficult to produce with conventional manufacturing, but it is not a problem for additive manufacturing. Similar solution from VTT from Finland, where they built an electrical machine rotor with hollow structure to reduce rotor weight and enhance the machine performance. Here is with lattice structure rotor to enhance the cooling capability, and reluctance machine with, again, different reluctance channels to enhance the machine performance. Here is example of assembled machine from Chemnitz University of Technology. Chemnitz University, they claim that they have built a full machine with additive manufacturing, so there is missing characteristic what came out, so I don't know how well the machine is performing. Here is one example of 3D printed electrical machine idea of enhancing machine air gap capability. It's very interesting design, and again, we can already see that using additive manufacturing possibility can change a machine shape, how it looks like, what is usually not possible with traditional or conventional manufacturing way. And here is one example of a Porsche where they printed out full frame for electrical machine or drive system for electrical machine. Of course, we don't have to print everything from metal. Here is one example where the researcher were building a simple, very cheap solution with plastic electric motor. The important part why I brought it out is that they implemented electronic directly into the machine frame. And this one is something where the electrical machines are moving, as this one is offering new possibility for electrical machine. Only problem is that the electronic and electrical machine are working in different temperature, and from this point of view, additive manufacturing is giving us new opportunities how to cool the system and possibility how to implement the electronics directly into the machine. We can produce different windings. Here is some example how to increase the winding factor of the machine, or how to increase winding factors, or some example of the printed windings with the cooling channels in the winding, but they are still in very early stage of research and it have to go further. Additive manufacturing possibilities are also giving us new possibility to optimize the machine. Here is one example, as we have conventionally basically almost optimized machine, but now through shaped optimization we can produce even more complicated reluctance channels or flux barriers, what are enhancing the machine characteristics and reducing machine weight, but keeping machine performance at the same level or even better. But the optimization is quite difficult tool. We can optimize all part of the machine. We can optimize machine topology, dimension, material, electromagnetic part, structural part, thermal, control, process design, and so on, and using different optimization tools. Here is one example what we have done in our lab in early research, how to reduce one magnetic clutch weight, what is 3D printed out. Here is the initial design, and through optimization we made basically reduce the amount material. By this we were able to reduce the weight of the material 20%, but keeps the clutch performance in the similar stage. Here are other examples what we have done in our lab. This one is totally our first prototype, just to look how the concept is working. Here is the machine itself. It's a nice small stepper machine, but we already see that there are some problems with printing. Also, we have done some case study for comparing the conventional transformer with same transformer, but the core part is printed out with additive manufacturing. We can see some drop in the performance, and we were expecting it because this one, this solution is not yet optimized. It is only showing the concept that it is possible to build functional transformer part and get almost the same characteristic out of it, and it is still need additional work to reduce eddy currents, and then definitely we get to the point where it is comparable with traditional machine. Also, we are working at the moment on a machine. We can see here printed out rotor. We can see here printed out stator of the asynchronous machine, and here we can see a small video about how the printing process is going of the asynchronous machine rotor. Here we also implemented a special method how to reduce eddy currents, but that we are not able yet to fully test the machine, but it is already getting there. We can see already the machine is almost winding process here, and it is already winded here. And hopefully soon, if we are will follow our papers of our groups, and probably you can see also can look out what characteristic is giving out this asynchronous machine. So to summarize, what are the additive manufacturing possibilities for electrical machine? Basically, there is endless possibilities, but at the moment the research is still in the early stage, and there is still a lot of work to do. We have to work with new machine concept, new design concept, and of course the manufacturing technique is also advancing.